Michigan Tech's Biomedical Engineering Department, Team 6, paired with Resolve Surgical Technologies to tackle the characterization of laser weld strengths on orthopedic devices designed and manufactured by Resolve this far. It is used in spinal fusion operations, and these devices are used as guides for bone screw placement and insertion, which utilize laser welds and are currently classified as seal welds. Attachment methods were divided into pin and edge models. The objective of this project was to create test models that can be utilized for characterization of laser welds. Torsional and bending forces are the most important when considering how the instruments are used during surgery. Our design included a custom mount for the test pieces to be inserted into the machine. This design would complement the mounting mechanisms of the MTS Mini Bionics device available on site. Our two assemblies were designed to mimic the current instruments manufactured by Resolve. The male ends of both devices were sized to match in order to improve manufacturing efficiency, while one female end was designed to replicate the bed of the edge weld and another to replicate the pin weld. Assemblies sought to create variance in weld volume by differing shim size between parts in the pin design and weld length in the edge design. Testing was conducted by Resolve employees. Torsional and three-point bend fracture tests were performed in addition to tests that applied forces sourced through team testing. For the pin weld variability during torsion testing, up to 0.003 inches is passable of the strength significance, but allowing up to 0.006 inches while passable has a high variability, which makes strength unreliable as of testing this far. The edge weld lacks strength capabilities by not reaching our strength significance. However, we can classify the edge weld as a seal weld, but not a functional weld. Pin weld strength under three-point bend testing shows low significance between the gap widths, but 0.006 inches has high variability, showing lower reliability, thus defining the weld strength is not recommended. For the edge weld, we found that the orientation of the force acting upon the device directly affects maximum strength and variability. When the part was tested with the bedside up, there was little variability in the data. But when the pin side was down, the data was significantly different. For future projects, there could be more testing on the 0.006 inches gap to prove the reliability of the weld strength. Additional testing to define a specific gap length to idealize strength for medical devices. As a result, we found that pin welds satisfy torsional strength thresholds and improves functionality. Pin welds under three-point bend showed no significant difference. Edge welds under torsional strength testing failed to reach strength at a predetermined threshold. An edge weld under three-point bend shows orientation-defined strength. The team believes that the project can be continued under the supervision of faculty of the Material Science Department, but they focus on exploring laser weld penetration depths and volume of welds without the need to design test models. Developing a non-destructive method of predicting and measuring weld volume and penetration based on welding specifications could prove useful to any laser weld utilized in the entire industry. Acknowledgements go out to the Resolve Surgical Technology Team, as well as the Michigan Technological University advisors, Dr. Sang Yoon Han and Dr. Bruce Lee. Thank you and have a good day.